over. I know we had a little bit of a concern during our last training, and I know we started back up, but I still feel like, and I know that Lori had expressed the idea that some people are still kind of lost on the two types of lesson plans that can be planned for. One is one that they can draw from the activity library, and the other is one that they can create. So I've asked Amy to go back over just sort of that both of those, so we can see the functionality and kind of recap what we went over the last time. And then the other thing is that I think that might help. We're going to allow you to kind of play around with it a little bit, get to know it a little bit better on your own, and then we would like to schedule a time to physically come out to the site, whether it's at your downtown office or wherever you feel best suits your needs, to physically be there to go over the program and how to use it and so forth as well. So I thought that maybe if we mentioned that up front, it would take a little bit of pressure off trying to hear, and I know you're kind of struggling with that as well. But the other thing that Amy wanted me to remind everybody is that in the meantime, before we get this physical visit set up, as you're working through the profile planner, as you have questions, you're more than welcome to contact or email Amy, and she can kind of step you through some of your individual issues as well. So I just wanted to say that up front before we get started.
That sounds like a good plan.
Okay, and I'll get back to you with a time. I know Mondays usually work better for some sites and so forth, and we'll see how to best set it up, and we'll let Lori roll out the schedule and location and so forth, if that's okay.
Okay. Yeah, that sounds really good, and I'll make note of that too for Lori.
Okay, thank you.
Okay.
Okay, so I'll turn it over to you then, Amy. I'm going to mute. I have a cold, and I get this dry cough, so I'm going to mute so you don't have to all listen to it.
Okay. Amy, I'm gonna mute ours also.
Okay. And if anybody has any questions, just jump off of mute and interrupt me as I'm talking.
No problem.
So hopefully today I'm gonna go back over the searching and adding activities from the database and also adding in your own activities. And then if anybody has any questions after that, I really want to spend the remaining time answering those questions. So if you've thought of anything prior to the session or you have any questions as I'm going through, then we definitely want to make sure we have those questions answered. And like Marisa said, if you're going through after this session and you're trying to do your plans and having trouble with anything, just feel free to call us or email me, and we're happy to set up a one-on-one training session or just email back and forth or get on the phone. So we're here to help you guys. We know there's a lot of stuff you can do within Profile Planner. You can't learn it all at once. It took us forever to learn how to do it. And we're always updating things as well. So things like updating the database, you may not actually see or be able to tell that there are new activities there. But every once in a while, you'll see an icon that looks a little different. And so we also try to do training webinars and record those for any updates that we have. So in the future, when we have those, just be on the lookout for those emails that will let you know we have a new video you can watch to learn about the new features. So in your account for this training classroom, I have added some activities for today, just so you guys can see what it will look like on your home page. So when you sign in and you have activities scheduled, you are going to see those here. Another great thing that you guys may want to use are these YouTube tutorial videos. So you can click this link and actually go to our full iActive Learning YouTube channel. And then we have a couple videos just by themselves on this page as well. So we'll take a look at the calendar. So I am looking at a day view. My day is starting at 7 o'clock. So I'm seeing all of those activities that I have scheduled. So last time we talked, we did spend a lot of time talking about routines and setting those up. So I'm actually going to go into my routines report. So I just went to reports and the daily routines link. So now I'm still looking at a daily view. And so for each routine that has an activity after it already, I'm seeing that activity name. for all of the routines that don't yet have an activity assigned to them, I'm just seeing that routine name. So this is a day where I have some routines that are filled in and some that are not. I think if I look at tomorrow, I'm only seeing those routines. So I know that I still have to do some scheduling and adding activities to those, so I know actually what I'm doing at 7 o'clock and 9 o'clock and 9:30. So on the right-hand side, again, is the search menu. I'll go ahead and do a fresh search. So maybe we'll look for fall activities. So I typed in my keyword. You can hit enter or just this magnifying glass underneath it. And right away, my results are sorted by book. So if I am looking for art and craft activities, I can expand that folder. And these activity names have to do with fall, and they're from that art and craft activities book. If I click on any activity name, this is where it's going to let me know that basic information about the activity. So again, the book it comes from, the targeted age group and topic and learning centers. And this is also how I can view a PDF of every activity. So right here, I'm seeing all of my materials, instructions, and it's exactly how it looks like in the book. If for some reason you don't have internet access, this is definitely something you could print out. And if you wanted to send an activity home with a child, then you could also print that out and send that home with them. And now to add this to my calendar, I drag and drop this icon. I'm going to put it in that creative arts routine, so I dropped it right on top of that, and it populated that field for me. So it also populated the start time and end time for me, because that's what I've programmed that routine to fit into. All of this information at the bottom, again, you can edit or update. So if you wanted to change any of the instructions or even the materials, you could do that. Many of the activities already have recommended books and music that go along with them. But if you don't have access to one of these books, you can absolutely swap it out. You can also add in any music that you might want to play to go along with this activity. The standards are really important, as you guys all know. So these standards are recommended to go along with this activity. So I can even choose from the entire tree of these standards if I wanted to choose any additional standards. And what's really nice about this is that it's actually letting me know where this standard came from. So as a teacher, I'm also learning what I'm accomplishing with this standard as I look back to see that it's actually an approaches towards learning standard and it's about creativity. So I can assign those standards. If I choose just to keep standards that are recommended instead of looking through that entire tree, I can do that as well. So when I save this activity, when I go back into it, it will keep these bullet points letting me know that I have selected them on my own through that full tree of the standards. And these checkboxes will remain here to let me know that I have just gone with the recommended standards. So now that I've saved this activity, it has become part of that routine for tomorrow. So we can add a couple more activities. Let's see. I'm actually going to go ahead and sort my results by Learning Center, because this is how you can save a lot of time while you're doing your planning. You know, if you're talking about a specific keyword like fall or even neighborhoods or families, you can do one search. And all of these results show up by Learning Center. So they're all in one place, and you can just drag and drop, and it makes planning really fast. So I'll look for a language and literacy activity. And again, I will just drag and drop this activity right onto that routine name. If for any reason it drops into the wrong routine or maybe you missed the slot and it doesn't populate that for you, you still have the ability to update that here. And it will also populate that start and end time for you again. So I'll go through and check these out. This is an activity that I could add my own books to because there aren't any recommended books for this particular activity. And I'll select some standards again. And now it is part of my lesson plan. So going back to my actual lesson planning calendar, if I take a look at tomorrow, I'm only seeing those activities that I have added. So I know we talked about this with routines, but sometimes it's a little bit confusing because you know that you're going to have the arrival time and circle time and language and literacy every day. But what a routine is just that block of time. So you know those events are occurring every day. But the activities actually tell you what to do during those time frames. So once you've added activities to those routines, that's what actually shows up on your lesson plan. The activities are also carried over to the reports. We also have several reports that display the routine as well. But this is where the bulk of the information for your day-to-day schedule comes from. If I wanted to add my own activity, I can just click in any white space in this lesson planner and also in that daily routines report. So I can add in as much or as little information as I'd like. So let's see. I'm coming up with this on the fly, so you guys might have to bear with me a little bit. And maybe we will put this in our fine gross motor routine. So when I selected that, it populated that start and end time for me that I've already chosen. And then I can also choose a learning center. Maybe we'll do, I'm already figuring out that my activity isn't quite matching up with what I've said it's going to be. So now when I click through on these tabs, no information appears. So any information I add here will be populated on my reports. So maybe I'll add a couple different things here. I can still add in books and music. And with the standards, it does give me the ability to go through this tree and assign my own sets of standards. So if you choose, you can do that for the Ohio State standards as well as the Head Start standards. So I'll save that, and it becomes part of my lesson plan. So that's the activity that I just added on my own. And then if I take a look at the search menu on the right-hand side, I think it actually takes about 5 minutes to update the database. Actually, it's already there. So this is that activity that I just added. So now it's become part of my database. And again, it's under that My Activities folder rather than Activities. So you can click on that and even just drag and drop it onto your calendar just like any other activity. So that information that I just added carries over in these tabs. It's also letting me know which standards I've assigned to this activity previously. So it's really good to know that if you've already spent this time adding in this activity, you can just go back into your own database and drag and drop it onto your calendar. You also don't have to worry about this activity populating anybody else's database. If someone else is linked to your classroom, then they'll have access to this activity. But even in your own center or site, nobody else will have this activity except for you. So you could choose to print out a summary of this activity or anything that you've already typed in, but they would actually have to add it to their own database as well. So are there any questions about searching or adding activities?
I'm getting no sign that they have questions, so you can move on.
Okay. Well, now I actually just want to open it up to any questions that anybody might have about anything they've seen, or if I've missed something, then ask away.
Anybody have a question?
When you add the activities from the activity grid on the side, does the standard automatically pop up?
I was hearing about every other word of that, so I'm not sure if somebody could rephrase or repeat it.
Hold on, she's coming closer to the speakerphone here.
Okay.
When you choose an activity, or you add an activity to the calendar, when like you did family gathering, when you added family gathering and you added the family, the roles of the family, does the standard automatically adjust to what the topic you chose?
It does not. You'll actually have to choose your own standard if you add your own activity in. So I could even just click on a blank spot, and I don't have any information typed in, but I can still go to that standards tab. So every time you do add an activity, you'll want to click this assign standards button. So then you could go through and select your own standards for each activity that you've added.
So then you could just go through there and choose the standard that you want to choose for that particular activity. Okay.
Right. And then the next time that you use that activity, once you've already put it into your database this way, when you drag and drop it, the standards that you've chosen to associate with this activity will show up. So you don't have to do this every time you use that activity. But every time you add a new activity with your own information, you will have to choose your own standards.
Anybody else? Could you repeat what you said about if you choose an activity and it goes into your database, what did she say about the rest of the people being able to
add? They can't.
They can't. That's what I thought she said. So if they wanted to do the activity, you would have to give it to them?
Can you review how to create the schedule?
Sure.
Like, because you start with a blank, like, you already have some of your areas, like your times, you know, marked, like,
arts and
crafts time.
Yeah.
So how do I put gross motor in there again, or, you know, whatever I want to call that time of day?
Okay. So you'll actually go through your setup. It's this little gear icon on the toolbar, and then into planner management.
Okay.
So another thing to remember as you're going through in terms of setting up and even just getting used to the planner is that you can hover your mouse over any of these icons and a little pop-up will let you know what each one does. So this is telling me set up and manage your planner. Another thing is with these links, there's a little summary of what they are underneath them. So that can be really helpful too. So you know when you're looking to set up things like gross motor, you're going to want to go into your routines because those are blocks of time for your activities. I'm going to click on those routines. And right now you're seeing a lot of routines. So I could clean this up and even have one that's duplicated, so I could delete that one. And maybe, let's see, if we're going to do circle time but not group time, I could delete that one as well. And if you want to change any or edit them, you would just click this edit link on the right side. So I'm in my centers routine. Maybe we'll have this one start at 8 o'clock and last for 30 minutes. And then you can update with the color as well. So when I save that, I can see how it's updated in my table. And if you want to just organize them, I recommend just clicking that start time up the top of that table. So that way you can see everything that you've assigned, how long it's going to last. So when you're trying to organize everything, that can just make it a little easier.
Thank you.
So now I can click this link at the bottom left-hand side, and it will take me right to that routines report. So this is what we were looking at earlier. I just added that centers routine, so now it's showing up on this report as well.
Anyone else?
No. I have a question about groupings. I have an AM and a PM session. Should I, when I put my kids into, I put in the AM class. So I just assigned them to, I just created an AM group. Should I have just two groups with my one classroom, or should I have two separate classrooms?
That's really up to you and what you would prefer. If you choose to just do an AM and a PM group, then it would just keep everything together. So even in terms of routines, if you have the same types of routines, then when you are back in this routine setup, you could say maybe AM center time or PM center time. So that way you could add activities and you'll have different activities with different children. You could choose to set up a different classroom if you wanted, but it's really up to you. That would just require switching into a different classroom. So either way will work just fine.
Thank you.
Can we see a copy of the actual lesson plan, what it will look like after we put our activities in?
If someone has a lesson plan that you could send me, then I can actually kind of duplicate it in the planner and then send it back to you guys so you would be able to see it. Right now, I have like the routines that you guys use, and so those should be under your list of routines. But if someone has a lesson plan available, then I could absolutely set that up for you guys so you would just have something that would look a little more familiar.
Okay. Thank you.
Rich, I think that would be a good idea for the next time she see her that she already has one of our lesson plans for the people set up network and she doesn't really see
Amy, I'll make sure Lori gets you a copy of one.
Okay.
What she said is she's going to come here at a later date, and we'll have a training like out at George Forbes in the lecture hall where she can actually sit there. And
I do have another question. For some of our routines, we actually have the kids divided into two small groups, and those groups may or may not be doing the same activity.
Okay.
So can I have two activities run from like 10 to 10:30 and have it show on there?
Absolutely.
Okay.
So I'm going to go back to my routines report and just click that link from the routine setup. So if I wanted to add another activity, maybe to this creative arts routine, and I can choose another activity. I can drop it on my schedule. And I think sometimes when you're adding another activity, you may actually have to choose it from this list in terms of the routine, but it will still choose that start and end time for you. Just the same way as you added the other activity, you can go through all of the tabs. You can choose separate standards to go along with this activity. And then when I save, it's going to show up. It looks a little bit like two routines, but it still is telling you it starts at 9 a.m.
Mm-hmm.
And then when you go back to your lesson plan, it will actually show them at the same time.
Okay, great.
Anyone?
Are there any other questions?
As far as adding initials, because you have to add initials for each group, how will we do that?
If you have to add initials just in terms of the kids that will be participating?
Yes.
Okay.
And the teacher.
Okay. You can actually load in your full roster of children. So if you go into setup, there is a link for children. So if you add a child, maybe I'll just add myself. The child school ID doesn't have to be populated. If you guys use that, then you can fill that in here. Then you can update this information. You can also upload a picture of them. Any comments that you add here will just be kept private for the teacher, so you don't have to worry about parents or anybody else seeing this information. And now that I've clicked save, I can see this will form a table of all of the children that you've added in your classroom. So I'll go back just into an activity that I have scheduled. Now I can look at this children tab, and I have my roster here. I can check that box for individual children. Mm-hmm. And I can save that, so it will let me know that I'm participating in that activity. And then another thing that you might find even better is to go into the groups. So that was just set up again, and then groups. So you can add a group. Maybe we'll have morning children. You can edit that at any time. You can remove it. And then when I click the roster up at the top, it will show you the children that are already in that group. And at the bottom, it will show you a list of children that are available to add. So once you've added multiple children into your classroom, those will show up there. And when you click that add button on the right-hand side, they become part of that group. And now, I will take a look at another activity. And then into the children tab. So I'm seeing the individual children up at the top. So you'll probably have a list of multiple children. And then at the bottom, you'll have all of your groups that you've created. So if this was an activity just for your morning children, then you would just check that box. So all of the children that were a part of that group will now be a part of that activity. Did that make sense?
Yes.
Okay.
Is it a separate one for teachers?
A separate one for teachers that might be doing the activity or in charge of that activity?
Yeah.
That's a good question. I'm not sure that we've ever had anybody use it in that way, but you could definitely add teachers maybe as children in the classroom and create a group. So if you had a group of teachers teaching that particular activity, you could do it the same way. Okay. Another thing that you could do for just any activity is add any type of notes. So maybe even just on top of the instruction, you'd say, Ms. Phillips is teaching this activity. You could also even put it in the title of the activity so that way it would appear right on your lesson plan. Actually, we'll take a look at a report. Maybe we'll look at the detailed daily list, because this will show you all of the information about those activities that I have scheduled. So I can look down here at this activity that I just added this information to. And again, up at the top, it's just letting you know anything that you've edited. Are there any other questions right now?
I see shaking of heads that says no.
Okay. Well, again, if you guys get started planning and you have any questions, don't be shy at all. I promise I've answered every question you could possibly imagine. And so I'm happy to talk to you one-on-one if you're more comfortable via email or over the phone. Whatever is best for you, we're here to help. So don't be shy, don't be nervous, and feel free to reach out to us.
That we will.
All right. Well, it looks like we only spent about 30 minutes today, so
yep.
I guess you guys can enjoy a little bit of free time.
Not too loud. Thank you.
Well,
Amy.
You guys have a great day, and thanks for joining me again today, and I'm sure I'll see you guys very soon.
All righty.
All right. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thanks. Bye.